Thank you, Willen, for the amazing keynote. So we're moving from one thought leader to another thought leader. I'd like to introduce to you and invite Mr. Raja Ukkil. So he's the Senior Vice President and CIO at Wipro Limited. As the CIO, he's responsible for leading and transforming IT strategy, applications, infrastructure, and enterprise security support and execution. He's a change leader with around 25 years of experience in driving technology-enabled business transformations, optimizing efficiency, producing productivity gains. He's been spearheading the digital transformation journey of Wipro's internal IT. He has a very diverse background spanning across manufacturing, consulting, and services industry. So put your hands together for Mr. Raja Ukkil.
Good morning. I think everybody needed a break, so I don't think it's a good idea. Should we wait? So, you know, I didn't write that introduction, so I was not even aware of it till I saw it. And I'm not as serious as it looks in that picture. Okay? I'm just not a Facebook type, right? I mean, so thank you, Indus, for giving me the opportunity, right? I have one disclaimer here. Any of you who have been to Max Attention Forum recently in Bombay, I use the same presentation. I've just changed the skin to mask. I promise I will talk something different from there, right? Is there anybody in the room who went there? No. Then I can safely say what I said there, right? Means. So before I begin, so that we know the context, you know Wipro. So let me tell you, our industry is very different from pick, pack, ship, manufacturing engines and all that, right? Means. So we work in consulting, IT and BPO operations for our customers, right? So we are an $8 billion organization with around 170,000 plus employees, which are spread across 175 cities in the world. And average age of that workforce is around 28, okay? So 60% of the population could be below that, right? I mean, so, we are a few exceptions which are there. So largely our set of challenges are very different from what you heard till now, right? I mean, so we are not so-called the professional services industry, right? For some reason the world believes we are. So we are not a restaurant, we are not a hospital, we are IT and IT services, right? So we have completely different set of requirements. So what are our requirements? When we polled, I have been 2.5 years in this role. In my life, I have managed Wipro's SAP practice, so I understand ERP, well, right? I have also done implementations myself. I used to make a lot of money, right? Means charge out at very fabulous rates for doing very complex things, right? Means so our requirements when we polled users, they said, we did a time and motion study and found out that people use 17% of their time on an average doing internal stuff, okay? That usually, would not one-to-one translate into revenue for the company if it became zero. But that's a lot of productive time lost. And I'm sure that many of you, in your own experience, right, within your organization will realize that, right? Whatever be the complex business process, we have no business making employees, including very senior employees, to the developers who are developing and testing products for customers, spend 17% of their time on internal. So we had a desperate need to simplify things, right? Much has been talked about, but about this topic. To the best of my knowledge, the iPhone has one button, right, which is circular, right? Means here, don't think it is a blue iPhone, it's just a case, right? Means so there is one button here. Anybody can guess how many functions are there in an iPhone? At last count, it was 173,000 functions, okay? Have you ever felt that the iPhone is so complex a device that it has so much of things that it does not have, right? All of us use Uber, right? Before that, taxi hailing was very simple. Bangalore did not have cabs, okay? You couldn't generally stand on the street and wave your hands. You could do that in New York, in London, but not in Bangalore. And then, you get in and the fellow says, I don't want to go, right? Means it happens all the time, middle of the night, desperate situation. Now everything is very simple, but the back end is very complex. You know, it's all GPS coordinated. You know, my daughter was taking a Uber somewhere. She's 19 now, right? And like a very concerned dad, I had to know that she was safe in a cab, and it was like 10 o'clock in the morning on a Saturday. So I could track her progress on my Uber app as well, right? I mean, so it's essentially, if you look at the background process, it's very, very complex, but it's become very simple for the user, right? Users don't really care, right? Means you don't need an IT to operate an Uber app, okay? I've been trying very hard to take my mother onto Facebook, right? Means she is probably 75 plus, okay? So once I demoed her Facebook, but she did not have any technical questions how I do it. It's just that she felt awkward being in Facebook at that age, right? I mean, so it's that simple which has become. So cutting this short, I think one of our biggest challenges is, as an organization, how is it simple for people to operate, take decisions, collaborate with people, and reach out faster to customers, right? One of the things one must realize that today, everything has become very fast. When I was the SAP practice head, we made millions of dollars in what is called SAP rollouts, right? So we would do an expansive blueprint, then we will do a pilot site implementation, and then we will take all of that to countries and we will localize that solution, right? So roughly, if you go to, and we are not the $800 or the $300 an hour charge rates, right? So every site you go to, you at least make, you know, $2 to $4 million, right? So it was merry time, right? One project would be at least $200 million, right? And you go all around the world, and we have done many of them. Today, have you heard anybody doing a 3-year SAP rollout? Have you? The time is gone, right? So nobody has the patience. So the technology is there. One needs to implement all of this is under 6 months, right? And that's reality, right? I know all this, most of these HANA programs. We have gone to Business Suite on HANA. It took us only 7 months in a very, very complex SAP environment to go from, we were ECC 6, and you will not believe it, we were on EHP 0, okay? And we were not even Unicode, right? All that happened in 7 months, and the damn thing worked, okay? We had 3-4 days of an up and down, but it's working like a charm ever since, right? Things have become faster, right? The things which we wanted to become faster have become definitely faster, okay? And to the magnitude of many, many times, right? I'll give you some examples. So when I took over, right, this was the, you know, with all due respect to my predecessors, people had very low hopes from the IT organization. It's not that it is the same set of people. It's just that the focus was very different. The focus was, how are we putting controls as mandated by finance, HR, right? Or people management or resource management is a major function, you know. So we have funny rules in the company saying that if you don't have a visa, you cannot raise a travel request. So I have failed to explain this to people, that if you don't have a visa, you can only go and smuggle out of the country in a container, you can't be going through immigration. So what's the need of putting it in our system, right? Means, so this was taboo. People didn't ask these questions earlier, right? Means, and therefore we had tons of complications. And some of you will relate to it, and we will have that in many organizations, right? So so this is our strategy, which we laid out, okay? And strategies don't change. You know, at this level, strategy will be the same, right? So what we said was, we said simplification, agility, and agility means what? And I have some one or two slides around each of these. Then around analytics, hyper-automation, and don't ask me the difference between automation and hyper-automation, okay? I'm equally confused as you are, but I'll try and give my own interpretation and explanation. And how do we have a connected enterprise, right? So let's take the example of simplification, right? So process and application simplification, thoughtful reduction, consolidation, and you can look at the benefits, right? So let me give you examples of what simplification means, right? So one part of simplification is process simplification. You have a lot of controls, you have a lot of approvals, right? You know, anything you do, your manager has to approve, right? The best part was when we reviewed this, the manager had no way of knowing from the system whether he or she could approve or reject, okay? So it was, first it was there and nobody questioned it. And second is the manager would send an email or make a phone call and say, hey, what does it mean, right? How much will it cost? Okay, why can't you avoid it? Can't you do a video conference, travel requests and other things like that, right? So the system get no intelligence. All we did was entering data and at best some very static type reports used to come out that also would be dated, right? So that is one part of simplification. We said that we did two, three things. One is we evaluated, there are only four things important to us in the company and I'm sure for every organization. One is called top line or revenue of the company. The second is bottom line, which is the operating margin. The third is customer satisfaction and fourth is employee satisfaction. There is nothing else which we measure in the company. Now people interpreted these four things in a variety of ways. So we ended up having 800 KPIs, you know, if you did a cumulative sum of various teams in the company. So we started looking at processes in, and does it contribute to top line, does it contribute to bottom line, etc. And then the rest was easy, you know, you could just simply remove if they added no value. The other benefit which have accrued out of this was, you needed a workforce to manage those transactions, right? Because every process is not straight through in a complex organization. There are exceptions. So you will have major shared services centers, you know, major finance executives, HR executives, who would, all they would do is deal with exceptions on a daily basis. And, you know, so the moment we simplified the process, made it more straight through, eliminated controls and approvals, it became simple. So that was one part of the simplification which we did. The second part, what we really did, and I'll give you an example, or as a corollary to this, what we did was we realized that, you know, all these approvals and controls don't make sense. People are grown up, right? You know, when I passed out of college, I didn't have to be told by anybody where I will work, right? Whom I would marry. Okay, largely my parents were, you know, a little progressive, so they let me marry whomever I wanted to marry, right? And so, but in an enterprise, we seem to tell every employee what they have to do and what they have to. So we realized that, you know, empowerment is missing. So if things are there, you know, it gets upward delegated saying it's not my problem, right? You approved it, so you must be the old wise man who knows a method by which you have approved this. So what we did was, everybody either in Wipro has a top line target or a bottom line target or both, right? So we said that when you prepare an operating plan, and the funny part was the operating part of the plan was in Excel and PowerPoint. You have said, this is the percentage of my other costs. Suppose somebody makes $100 million and has said, 1% is my travel cost which will incur through the year. So now we have digitized it. We have given that fellow 1% of his revenue forecast and said, no approvals, you please manage within that. Now there is a catch. If that forecast from 100 million becomes 120 million, it still remains 1%, right? If it becomes 80 million, it is still 1%, right? And not 1% of 100 million, it is 1% of 80 million. That is driving a right sense of ownership and empowerment within the organization, right? And I think that's important. The second part of simplification is simply, you know, what the applications can do. You know, I'm a big fan of the fact that applications can mask a lot of complexity if they are done well, right? Typically, if you go to any self-service application, you will see that once you log in, you will be displayed with your name, your father's name, your blood group, your age, your gender, okay, the city you work out of, and then there will be five more tabs where you will actually go and do the transaction, okay. My question is, do I not know my father's name? Why I need to be told by the system, right? Nobody else tells it, right? Means if you go to all this e-commerce sites, they don't tell me what is my blood group and all that. This is a very simple registration process. And it just tells me what is my order history, which is contextual. The rest of the stuff I know. So, you know, you can do a lot of simplifications, which is what we did. To give you examples, we realized that, you know, there were 252 unique approval transactions in Wipro, right, across everybody. And outside of this, there were mail approvals as well, because, you know, when you become an organization with approval culture, if you have to go home early, you will ask your boss, can I go home, okay? And you need a record of that in a in an email. So it was driving a very wrong culture and a wastage of time. So we said, how would a manager who has to do 50 approvals know where all to go and to approve? So we asked people. They said, no, it is like Chinese whisper, you know, the initial first 2 years I used to have a printout, but then you guys started introducing so many approvals, okay. So I have a team which actually finds out what is changing and tells me, you know, you see the corner of that board, you know, the new ones are listed there, so every time I have to do that. So I said, how do you know with the approval? So there are mails which come out of the system. In that mail, it will be said where I have to go and do it. But in case, sometimes the mail is inconsistent with this. So I said, what do you want? So he said, so this guy is an industry leader. So he is, you know, more on Emirates than in office or in front of a customer, sadly. So he said, you know, I get Emirates now Wi-Fi, he travels business. So it would be very cool if I could go to one app, either on my phone or tablet or on my Surface, whatever device, and I could do all of that from one place. So I said, this is an ask even I have. I mean, I have to approve so many things because I'm also a buyer in some sense. So we came out with this app. What it did was it exposed REST services from all the different applications, right, and brought it into one place. Today you can see the status, you can approve. It has some degree of intelligence in analytics. You know, so for example, if I approve a travel, I can see what was my budget, how much I have approved till now, within this month, quarter, and with this approval, where it will take it to, and what will be the unbalanced budget. Isn't it something which is useful? And it's, you know, it's incredibly hard to do, okay? You have to deal with 149 application owners, and tell them, please write a REST service which will bring here, which will take care of all these exceptions. And you know, it took us time to do it. But once we did it, so there are multiple examples like this, right? Requests, IT requests, stationary requests, you know, visitor passes. I'm sure every organization has this differently, right? You have to, some are you have to send a mail, some you have to call, you know, then you have to go to 55 applications to do it. These are very easy to consolidate, right? That user experience is very, very important. The third bit of simplification is a concept, right? Means people I have seen in 170,000 people, and I'm not a behavioral scientist or anything, there are various aptitude levels when it comes to IT usage, right? If you think everybody thinks the same, you're mistaken, right? What is the biggest challenge in technology today? Technology can do a lot of cool stuff. The biggest challenge is adoption, okay? So I'll tell you an example. So there is this buzzword called unified communications, right? In, you know, in SAP forums, you may not hear all that, but if you go outside to a Cisco forum or a Microsoft forum, you will hear a lot about it. So what does it mean? To me, it means that I should have one app from which I can call audio, I should call video, I should join an audio bridge, video bridge, I should be able to chat, I should be able to, you know, participate in a communication within a group, community. Is that how the world is? What is the real world? You have a Cisco infrastructure, you have a Skype infrastructure, right? You will have a WebEx, you will have an audio bridge provided by BT or Orange Business Services, right? And therefore, you have 5-6 apps and to manage this. And, you know, and invariably, if you have not done it smartly, you will end up having 5 credentials and 5 different passwords, okay, which, unlike a car registration number, you can't pay excess money and get a preferred number, right? Means, so the password which will come from BT will be one. And because of security, every other day, those IDs are becoming longer and longer, right? So earlier it used to be very simple, 4, right, digit. Now it has become some 10 digit. So most of us cannot remember our spouse's mobile phone number, right? If you lose our phone, that's it, okay? You have to physically go home and talk to your wife. So that is unified communication, and there is a lot of research going on. I found, how many of you, and be honest and raise your hands, if this was a video conference room, how many of you, if I gave you a bridge number and told you this is the IP address of somebody in SAP you have to dial, how many of you can do it yourself? Okay? I am very impressed. I can't do it myself. You know why I can't do it? There are 2 remotes in the room. Okay? I can't operate. I don't know what it means. Okay? There is something called picture-in-picture which will arrive. Sometimes I will see my own face and not see the other end. There are huge complexities. When the world is dealing with simplification, I have always wondered why somebody can't come up with something like a magic remote which can deal with video conference rooms. Okay? So if you look at it, I don't think technology options exist to that extent where you can deal with one single app for all this related type of transactions where it's easy, right? You don't have to remember complex passwords. You can do it yourself and not rely on your IT department to connect you, right? All of us, I am a CIO, so, you know, my every year budget is a fraction of the previous year's budget, right? Means, I've been in consulting, tried to convince my boss and my CFO saying to come out with various metric which allows me to spend more. It doesn't happen, right? Means, so to deal with all this complexity, what happens is you carry large workforces, right? You keep on adding cost. I'm a firm believer that, almost like a statement, all of us who spend so much in IT will come down significantly with technology, right? Means today, 90% of our applications are on cloud, okay? So our mails is running on cloud, so, you know, we were on an on-prem exchange. We had 29 email administrators. Today we have 5 to allow for 24/7, okay? And we are on Office 365. It has never gone down in the last 18 months. So that is when technology will play a role in simplification, right? I am not too sure whether it is a Q&A format. I would love, if I'm off, I can stop anytime. So please feel free to stop me and ask questions, you know. I had 1 hour, I don't know whether I'll be cut short, but. Okay, so, you know, we did this, right? Means suit on Anana, business suite on HANA. And I'll also tell you why we are not on S4 yet, okay? So if you see the statistics here, I'll move, right? Fairly impressive, right? You look at the compression, right? Means we were 8.1 terabyte to 1.8 terabyte, right? We didn't expect that much compression to happen. You know, 40 hours downtime for such a complex migration was something which we didn't guess. We had actually announced to the organization that it will be a 60-hour downtime. So they were very pleasantly surprised when it came back up in 40 hours. We, of course, and I'll be dishonest if I didn't tell you that if there were no issues, 5 days after the cutover, there were issues because some of the custom programs which were there, though they were refactored when they went into production, and the concurrency became so high that they hit performance issues. So we, along with Max Attention, worked overnight stabilized it. What was interesting, and it was a very bold move actually, we went live the weekend before Sapphire started, okay? When it went live, I was on a plane to Orlando, right? Means, so when I reached there, so it was fun, right? Means I saw 17 missed calls, and 24 emails on why a batch program was failing and it was taking a lot of time. But overall, it was satisfying. So why have we not gone to S4 yet, right? The logical question was to go ahead with S4. So if you remember, we are an IT/ITES company, right? So the products which we use from SAP is our financials. We use core HR, the rest of HR we have written ourselves. If you look at the core order to cash process, right, we use people supply chain in a product called MRS, which is a standard product to the best of my knowledge. No, not standard, it's a custom. And then we have a product called C Pro, which is C Projects, which there are three companies in the world which use it. Us, SAP Consulting, and I don't know the third one, right? No, I know SAP is the second, right? So there is somebody else as well. So the point is that if you understand HANA, you know, the 1511 or the 1610, you know, does the code base change, right? The other products which we use from SAP are not certified on S4. So practically we have to run two parallel instances. So we are talking to SAP to see when they will certify all these other products. CPRO they may not certify, so we are looking at an alternative, right, to replace it. So, which is when we will do. We obviously have simple finance planned at some point. We have gone live with HANA fraud management. We also use HANA Sidecar for our enterprise analytics. So, you know, we had every other tool set in the, under the sun you can think of. We had, you know, we had ClickView, we had Oracle. We have done away with all that. Our enterprise data stores are on HANA Sidecar right now. So our capability to deliver near real-time reports are much better. And they have got integrated back into applications, even custom applications, to give you the analytics which is needed for decision-making. Okay. Agile, right? You know, so whenever there is a change in management, what is the first thing to do? Yeah, please. Sorry? Cost. If I tell it here, you know, some of my SAP friends will not like it. You know, we are good negotiators, let me put it that way. And our cost is not a representation of what you might spend because, you know, if, I don't know whether it goes back. Yeah, it goes back. So if you see, we had, including business users, 540 people. A significant chunk of that came from business, my own team. Obviously, I have an SAP team. And there was a lot of people who came over from the SAP practice, right? You know, we wanted people to get a first-hand feel of production deployments of HANA. So there were some people who were experienced, there were some people who had only practiced it in the lab. So, you know, after the event, if you want me, I will tell you the cost. Obviously, cost is a concern for any HANA deployment. But there are ways and means of defining business cases. You know, just don't look at it as what you spend versus what will be the increased spend. That business case will never fly. It's a question of business benefits and what are the savings you will get out of it, okay? That's important, right? Otherwise, I would not have gone it past my CFO, okay? So agility. So when a management, new management comes, nobody guessed, actually first they change the structure, right? You know, with all due respect to management, they believe that the current structure doesn't work, so they put a new structure. All our companies, including SAP, always has changes. Second thing is they change leadership, right? I mean, people will be pulled out from here, there, somebody will be given additional responsibility. I don't know how many of you are in IT. It is incredibly hard, right? It's almost like torturous on us when an org change happens. We dread the day when an org announcement comes back, okay? Because in 15 days, people ask, you know, expect all the processes will run as per the new structure, all reporting will happen, okay? Then, as if that was not enough, there will be acquisitions which people will do, right? And we have not done it yet. I have heard that some companies also divest some parts of their business, okay, which is an equally challenging task, right? Remember, when you put a strat plan on an operating plan, you can factor none of this. You can't say that I have assumed two management changes in the year, okay, three acquisitions, and one divestment. It is not possible, right? So therefore it becomes incredibly hard, and look back at your own landscapes and see how things are configured, right? Even including SAP, right? You know, you have to set up new series of cost centers, position hierarchies, you know, I can go on and on, right? It's incredibly hard, and then the damn thing has to work. It means it's not about changing. You have to do data migrations, it's middle of the year, right? We have now become experts in migrating data from one SAP instance to within the same instance, right? For a different configuration. That's the hardest, trust me. Because otherwise you can take out in an Excel sheet, convert into CSV, upload it, go do some smoke testing, etc. Here it is incredibly hard. So one expectation clearly is, can you deliver the process changes which we are implementing at a very quick speed, right? Much has been talked about DevOps, Agile, I will not go into that. In spite of all of that, trust me, it is incredibly hard, right? What I'm amazed is, you know, I speak to the Amazon guys as well. They are a different industry, different customer segments, etc. Do you know what is their release cycle? Any guesses? Amazon's release cycles? Every 89 seconds, they release an announcement, okay? So there must be something very, very different they are doing. Forget what industry, forget how simple or complex it is. 89 seconds, something or the new is coming up on the Amazon platform. And this is not I'm talking about the retail platform. I'm talking about Amazon Web Services, okay? Fairly impressive. You know, people have talked about Amazon not having a great work-life balance. I don't get there, but even with that, you know, there must be something fundamentally in their platform which allows this, and the way they have architected their IT, it's allowing them to release so fast. Obviously, infrastructure is a big bottleneck to an application development, right? First, you have to raise a request, then you have to get three quotes, okay, some of the same. You know, HP, Cisco, you can, Lenovo, whatever you can think of, Dell. Then you'll negotiate. By the time the hardware arrives, it is 2.5 months to 3 months, okay? And the requirement would have fizzled out and something new would have come for which that hardware will not be sufficient, right? So there is enough and more told, spoken about the benefits of cloud. I think infrastructure as a service is a given, right? It will cost slightly more though in Indian context, okay? So, you know, it's a question of CapEx versus OpEx. Companies like us who are cash rich are really not bothered about that, right? Means it's the same for us. We are more bothered about what is the hit on our operating margin. We took a call and today we are 90% of our application landscape is on public clouds, okay? So things around security, you know, access speed and all that, I can guarantee you are a myth, okay? It works beautifully for us. Things have become faster. The other benefit which nobody realizes, and I don't want to belabor this point, is that when you put everything on the cloud, then please don't make the mistake in a globally diverse organization trying to put up MPLS networks, right? Allow the damn thing to work on internet and it just works fine, right? Means. So 100% of our employees access anything today on internet, even from India, right? And it just works fine. Means, you know, our data centers are in Singapore, right? Nothing is in India with the public cloud, because Singapore, we trust with European data more than we trust India with European data. That's the sad part of it. So that's a huge cost savings which you'll get. So don't compare one, you know, 4-core VM to another 4-core virtual infrastructure inside. But infrastructure as a service is not the exciting part. What is exciting part is the standard applications that will let you simplify process. Okay, today we are implementing Ariba source to pay end to end, the cloud version, right? You should have seen at our procurement systems, right? It took us 22 days for a startup to register in Wipro to be an approved supplier. I'm not joking, okay? The questions were the same. Can you publish 3 years balance sheet? That fellow says, I am a startup, I'm not even A-level funded. I mean, so how do you expect me to generate 3 years balance sheet, right? Our processes are all like that. The service desk would not get it, right? So with Ariba, we will We'll hopefully do this. There are a range of things which we are implementing on SaaS. We are also doing a lot of stuff on the PaaS. The platform as a service, I think, is the most exciting part. You know, I always get confused between the two. The HANA Cloud Platform, it's called, I think. Okay, please try that. Right, means it will let you do amazing things. Okay, I don't know how much open source technologies it supports today. You know, before my SAP days, I used to manage Salesforce, and we used to develop applications on Force.com those days, right? 6-7 years back. You can do amazing stuff, not because of seasonal demand. You know, that's a cliche and a given. All these platforms are offering what is called microservices, okay? So today, if you have 50,000 lines of code, you know, in an application, if you go to a PaaS, and if you don't come down to 10,000 lines of code, okay, there is something wrong which you're doing, right? So you can do it faster, it's very repeatable. Everybody has tons of libraries of microservices, right? You know, you can call it microservices, these are all analyst coin terms, you can call it components, but the best part is anything you want to do is available there. The second thing is, today more and more global organizations, you know, and I'm just veering off, if you're doing applications, make sure that, you know, the world of backend has gone now, right? Remember earlier we never focused on the front end. We used to take tons of time developing database tables, relationships, complex ERD diagrams, right? And APIs, EDIs, you can point-to-point interfaces and all that. Today, the skill has completely changed. It is all about the front end, right? So if you can do 80% of your application development in the front end, and what do I mean by front end? It is the world of JavaScripting now, right? You know, people use Angular, we have now moved over to React, which Facebook uses. You can really deliver a superlative experience. Everything is cached, you can use CDN, where people can get, like Google, you know, local server access, so it's super fast, right? We just rolled out our performance appraisal new system, we call it Performance Next. 65,000 people filled out their, we have now made it quarterly discussion, so there is no rating and all that. 65,000 people filled out on the last day. Okay, this is the first time we had no issues. Okay, even if the network was not there, Wi-Fi not on, LAN not connected, application still working. There are ways and means of doing it, right? Means. So that's the exciting part. And people expect that to be delivered real quick. Analytics, okay? So, you know, there's been much talked about analytics, you know, since age-old days where, you know, so the world of ETL fortunately has gone with HANA, right? Means if you are only SAP, you know, if you are on S4, you can quickly expose all the data you need. You can integrate very easily. Ours is a mixed bag, so we use the sidecar. You know, we have what is called SLTs, which are near real-time replications. So you can give as much capabilities which you want in the front end, right, to users for decision making. The one request I have from SAP, and I've been requesting for 2 years too, is to make the visualization tools a little smarter, right? If Fury is coming out at too slow speed, right, means not Fury, what is it called? So earlier we had business intelligence, business objects, right, with all those, you know, car type, automobile type meters and all that. The world has changed, you know, there is D3 now, right, means which is open source. You look at the chart types, you will just get a floored, you know. The visualization is important because if you can deliver analytics and dashboards, drill downs, exception analysis, trend, etc., very quickly. See, HANA is a great database. I have no doubt in my mind. How you expose it and make it with single click, go, etc. You know, whatever you saw previously he presented, much of it takes quite an effort to build out, right? If you want to deliver, say, 100 reports a day, you need to have a framework which allows you to do it, right? Means you just load, user should be able to cut, slice, dice as they want, choose a chart type, publish it, boom, that's done, right? I mean, so that's the way analytics should be. Obviously, you know, prescriptive and predictive are both very important, so we have started working on it. We use our cognitive platform called Holmes for predictive analytics. Please be careful where you don't use cognitive, right? So for example, I should not be using a machine learning algorithm to predict my father's name. It will be a disaster, right? But where actually cognitive is required, please use cognitive, it's much better, right? I can give you an umpteen number of examples where the world changes when you use bots. So it was all reactive, right? Means I have worked in shop floor, by the way, production planning. I have run MRP, MRP2. Okay, I have run advanced supply chain plans, constraint based. So all we used to know was after the event. So I was very happy when I saw your chart, right? Means it's so refreshing to see that, right? I wish I could run plans and I have implemented subsequently, right? And try to convince hard, you know, how to set a time fence with some numeric values and dates and all that, and people would not comprehend what that meant, right? Those six columns. The second thing about automation is elimination of work, right? You can apply it at a range of things which are there, right? Means simple things like, how do you want your password to be reset? Let me ask you, this is, you know, my one of my favorite topics. Any guesses? You have passwords, right? I would assume no organization has no passwords. I wish it was. So most organizations call the help desk, right? And they will, you know, they will reset something and give it to you, right? Which is private to you. What are the other ways of doing it? You can create a mobile application, okay, on an OTP based. But that's not cool, right? If you're on Skype or, you know, SAP has something like that, a messaging platform where you can talk to somebody and say, hey, I lost my password, I forgot. Can you please reset, right? So it's a very different paradigm. So, you know, there is a strong school of thought and a lot of people are investing, saying that, you know, user experience does not mean complex UIs, right? What is, and it's the Google school of thought, right? You have a bar and you can do anything with it, right? We have deployed some of that, right? So demo was not permitted, but if I could do, I could show you a bar where I can go and write, I'm not feeling well tomorrow, I want to be on leave, right? And it will apply the leave, right? So that's something which is happening. Automation in IT is, operations is something which has been much talked about. People have not done enough. All those endpoint incidents which happen, all the network outages which happen, you can do wonders because these are more defined, right? The only thing which a cognitive will help there is to correlate an event to the solution, right? So we have seen, you know, last month in our IT infrastructure group, we typically get around 70,000 tickets a month, right? That's a hell lot, but we still get 70,000. Last to last month, we deployed 25 new automations based on, you know, visibility which we have into endpoints. These are related to endpoints. And last month, we had a dip of 10,000 tickets. So that resulted in a reduction of manpower as well, right? Most of the stuff was done silently, without the user even knowing. The user could snooze twice, right? Saying, not now, maybe later, right? Third time it'll go ahead and do it because it's a problem. Cloud and mobility, you know, if you are interested after the session, I can show you what is the problem with mobility, right? That again, you know, all the mobile apps needs to be downloaded on your phone. All of you use WhatsApp, I'm assuming, right? So everybody, some jokes and good morning messages, etc. will come. So the biggest, you know, nightmare in the world today is the phones don't have space, right? Means phones are there, you have to, every time you have to clean up space, right? Means I have a 64 GB, I really wish it was 500 GB, right? So downloading apps on the phones is not a good idea anymore, right? Single sign-on is another problem. If you have 55 applications and if you have to do a single, if you have to log in every time, right, is not a great idea. So we have gone through it. Second thing is, you know, any phone these days has a biometric, right? The question is why you have to put complex IDs at the rate, you know, SAP.com, Wipro.com, etc. So if you are interested, we can show you. We are working with a startup. It has touch integration, so I can touch and it just lets me in, boom, right? And it's secure. So when I leave the organization, it will get wiped. So those are user experience, which is very important. Today, 90% of all applications in Wipro are on the mobile as well. Okay, so you can sit anywhere, right? So I didn't come with my laptop today, right? Means I'm actually operational, right? I can take my phone calls, I can join an audio on a video bridge, I can do all my approval transactions, I can initiate a travel request, everything I can do from my phone. That's great user experience. Obviously, there will be, you have to be friendly with the CISO, take them out for coffee and lunch, maybe many times a week, to let you have some leeway in the time being, but that's what the users expect. Obviously, cloud is a great story, right? I don't think there is a... So where are we today, right? So we have deployed around 850 simplification ideas. So what we do is, we have done away from this requirements documents to what is called design thinking. This gentleman who is sitting there, I owe it to him. If you guys don't know him, please meet him during the breaks, okay? He's a great design thinking coach, okay? He transformed the way our IT operates. So we get everybody into a room for 3-4 hours. At the end of it, it is a working prototype, right? So there is no other method which we follow today, right? And when we simplify, what we do is we ask users, what do you mean when you say, what do you want? So we are working on an application today on mobile, which will be called Unified Expense App. We have not named it yet. So as you are traveling, if you are in a Starbucks, you take a photograph of the bill and you attach it, something like Expensify, right? And then you can attach it to a travel request of yours, which is open. And as you build it up, as you finish your trip, just press submit, boom, everything is gone, right? We've gone paperless with our claims today. I can guarantee you, you know, the Indian Company Act and the government does not require paper-based claims, okay? It's a myth. We have gone to the experts, studied it. In fact, they advise that you should keep it in soft copy. Okay, so this is where we are today. We are doing, you know, I wish we were Amazon. We are doing 10 releases a day, okay? 10 releases a day, so that's a huge amount of releases which we do. These are not bug fixes or data fixes. These are enhancements. So next in the queue, Ariba is going on, right? We are on old GL, so we have to report 22 different gaps, okay? 125 company codes, so there's a lot of reporting. With new GL and Simple Finance, all that will become much, much easier, right? We are trying to find out the CFO's time so that he can sponsor it. He is okay, but he is extremely busy. And then we will... we have not done enough on PaaS. When I say PaaS, you can add a lot of bells and whistles. So we will redo some of the applications which we have there. In summary, I think we are going through a lot of change. We are not very good in change management. So we change and expect that the management will happen on its own, right? So we're trying our best to make things which are very idiot-proof, right, means, or intuitive, right, so that users don't require training and all that. So it's a lot of hard work. The team is getting stretched and pushed from multiple directions. But we are happy with the progress we have made, right, means in a very short period of time. Remember, whatever we do is also a showcase for our prospects and customers, right? So that's also a charter which I carry. You saw in the introductions, this year CIO 100 in the US, we are the only Indian company which we have won an award, right, for innovation which we have done and the transformation which we have done for our IT. It's a big thing for us. There were 500 applicants, right, mostly US companies, global companies. So we were the only Indian headquartered company which has won it. So we'll receive the award middle of August, actually. So it's a very proud moment for us. It reflects, it's a vindication of sorts of the great work the team is doing. So, you know, that's all I had today. I don't know whether you have, sorry, I just wanted. So, if you have any questions, I'll be happy. Otherwise, we can.
We are.
Okay. So you should have told me earlier. Yeah, I don't. Okay, thank you very much.